In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can search our iPhone, including showing or telling our iPhone what we want it to search for. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at search on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Let's first look at how we search our iPhone. We basically have two ways to search the iPhone. I'm not going to be talking about Siri here. We're just going to be talking about basic searches. To search the entire iPhone, what I do is I just swipe down from the top here. And we want to make sure that we swipe down from this area here. It shouldn't say from the top. If we go to this area here or here, it's going to give us our control center. It's going to give us our notifications. That's not what I want to do. I want to access search. So in order to access search, what we do is we just swipe from this area here and we swipe down. And when I do, I have my search. What I'm able to do is type in here what I'm searching for. So that's one way. That's basically how I will usually do it, just swipe down. Now I'm in search here, and I want to get back to my home screen to show you the second way of using search or accessing search. How do we get back to our home screen? Well, basically what we do is we just swipe up. When I swipe up, it brings me back to my home screen. So I'm looking at my home screen. It doesn't matter which home screen I'm on. I want to do another search. Well, if we look here, you're going to see that we have this search here. When I tap on that, and that's all I have to do is just tap on it, it brings me to my search. Now, if you don't see that search, I'm going to go back to my home screen. I just swipe up. If you don't see this search here, what you may need to do is you may need to enable it. In order to enable that or show it on your home screen, what we do is we go over to our settings app. So I'm going to tap on settings. And then from here, what we need to do is we need to go to home screen and app library. When I tap on that, you're going to see that there's an option for search. And what I'm able to do is show it on the home screen. If this is not turned on, let's go ahead and turn it off. You're going to see that when I go back to the home screen, that search is gone. Basically, this now allows me to manage my home screens. I long press on it, and now I can manage those home screens. I tap on Done to get back, and I'm looking at my home screens here. I want to turn this into search. You go back into the Settings app, go back to your home screen and app library setting, and then what we do is we just turn this on. So let's go ahead and turn it back on, and now you're going to see I have search here. And it doesn't matter which home screen I'm on. You're going to see that the search shows up there. Now, if you want to manage your home screens, how do you do that? Now that this is turned into a search, how can I manage my home screens? Well, basically, all you have to do is just long press on it. So I'm going to long press on this, and when I do, it goes into jiggly mode. And now what I do is I tap on this one more time. So I tap on it, and I can manage the home screen. So I can still manage my home screens, even when search is on my home screen. You just have to long press and then tap on it again. Two-step process. So I'm going to tap on Done, and I'm going to leave search here. I like to have that there. All right, so now we know how to access search. What does it search for? Well, basically, when you use search here, what it's going to do is it's going to search the entire iPhone. It's going to search the entire iPhone for app names. It's going to look for content, content within Mail, content within the Files app. It'll even search the web. So let's take a look at a couple of examples here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to search Mail. So now I want to find the Mail app. What I do is I tap on search here, and then we type in here Mail. And you're going to see that as a top hit, it shows me the Mail app. So I tap on that, and I'm going to be able to open up the Mail app. But remember how I mentioned that it will also search content? Well, if we look here, it's searching the content of my Mail. I'm going to swipe up here a little bit. It's searching the content of my Mail. I tap on any one of those, and what it'll do is it'll open up that email message within the Mail app. In addition to that, it's also searching for Mail settings. So I'm able to access the different Mail settings on my iPhone here. And then we also have tips, Mail tips. We keep going down. I also have photos from mail. And then we have files here. Files is like the Finder on a Mac. It's where we access all of our different files. Well, it's also able to search that Files app. And then we can also search within apps, specific apps. Let's do another search. This time what we're going to do is we're going to search for myself. I'm going to search for Dan Wasink. So I type in here Dan Wasink. And you're going to see the first thing it does is it pulls up a contact. Then what it'll do is it'll search for different files that have Dan Wasink in them. This is within the Files app. I can also search my settings. In the Photos app, it's searching for photos of me. And in the Calendar app, it actually found my birthday. And then if I wanted to search the web, I can do that as well. It's searching websites there. So depending on what you're searching for, you're going to have different results here. Basically, just swipe up to view the different results, and they're all going to be categorized. So that's what it searches for, or the different results. Now, what we can do is we can exclude what it's searching for. Maybe what I want to do is exclude photos here from showing in my results. I don't want it to show photos. So I don't want my iPhone to search my Photos app. How can I do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go to our Settings app. So I'm going to swipe up here, and we go over here to Settings. Now what we need to do when we're looking at all of our different settings here, what we need to do is we need to go over to Search. This is where we can modify what it searches. So I tap on it, and then from here, I can set if I want to show recent searches as well as related content. I can also set what search engine is being used in Safari. And then you're going to see that we have a list of apps here. These are all the apps that are on my iPhone. This is where we can set what it searches for within an app. So let's go over to Photos. We're going to stick with my Photos. I don't want it to search for Photos. So I swipe up until I find Photos here. You're going to see I have Photos right down here. So now I tap on that, and we're going to have a few different settings in here. The first thing I can do is I can set if I want it to include the app in the search. Remember when I searched for mail, it came back with the mail app? This is why it comes back with that app. So if I were to search for Photos, it would come back with the Photos app, not the content, but the Photos app itself. So if you wanted to hide an app from search altogether, you can tap on that and it'll hide it. It will not show up in results, any results when you use search. Now, when you do have this on, you have another option. You can have it search content. So remember how it found myself in the Photos app? Well, if I were to turn this off, what it would do is it would hide those results. I would still see the Photos app in the result because that is turned on. I'd see the app itself, but I would not see the content because I have that turned off. So that's how you can set if you want to show the app itself and then the content within the app in your results. Now let's take a look at how specific searches work within an app. There's one tip that I basically want to share with you. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back to our settings. We're going to start out with the Settings app. And when we look at our settings here, you're going to see that I do not have any type of search. I swipe up. I can't search settings. Well, actually, you can. What we need to do is we just need to swipe all the way down. So I swipe, and when I do, you're going to see I have search here. A lot of times, this is going to be hidden. So when I swipe up, you're going to see that it is no longer there. I swipe down, and now you're going to see I have search. When I use this search, what it's going to do is it's going to search within the Settings app. So I'm not going to get a global search. It's not going to include Photos. It's not going to include mail. But what it will do is it'll include Photos settings as well as mail settings. So that's how you can search. Sometimes that is hidden. I'll show you another example, the app library. When I go to my app library, I have to go to the last home screen. Then I swipe one more. This shows me all of my apps. If we look up at the top, here we have App Library. It doesn't say search. Well, actually, that is a search. So I tap on it, and I can search. Let's take a look at files. I want to search my files. So I'm going to go to files. I'm actually going to search for it here. So I type in files app. I don't know where it is on my iPhone. And you're going to see I have files here. I tap on it, and I'm looking at my files. And when you go up to the top, we have search. Let's take a look at notes. When I go over to your notes, I don't have any type of search. But if I swipe down, look what we have, search. So sometimes what you may need to do when you're in an app is swipe down to show the search here. So there's a little tip for searching within apps. That doesn't always show, but in a lot of cases, if you just swipe down, you'll get to your search. So that's how search works, or the basics of search on the iPhone. How you can access it, the two different ways how you can access it, how you can exclude content from it, as well as how it works from within apps. Sometimes you need to swipe down. So that is how search works on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. While I have over 400 videos on YouTube, I have a lot more on my site, danstutorials.com. I've been working on my site a lot longer than I have been on YouTube. So how can you help support my site, or how can you help support my efforts? Well, my site is a membership-based site. But when you do become a member, I take out all of the ads of the video, so you're not going to see any ads. You have access to my AI assistant, which is modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. You have access to those. And then in addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.